Hey, ninjapreneur, Misty Dorman here from Life Ninja Training and mistydorman.com. I've gotten a few questions about a new tool that I'm testing out. I think I'll be using it quite often from now on, actually. And so I thought I would just record a quick video of how I'm using it. Now, right now, this tool does have a lifetime deal going on AppSumo. I will link that below if the AppSumo deal ends, which I think it probably will soon. I'll make sure to update the link for you. Okay, now this tool is called StreamAlive, and what it does is helps you create really cool engagement within your live meetings. It is designed currently to work with Zoom. You can do it on YouTube Lives. You can do it with Microsoft Teams and also in-person events. If you're using some other type of tool that can't broadcast to YouTube Live, then you may need to wait for an integration for that. But without further ado, I will try to show you how I have set this up. Okay, so this website is very simple. When you first come into it, after you're all logged in, you will see that you need to authorize any of these different platforms that you're using. So go ahead and walk through the steps on that. I have already connected my Zoom, which is what I'm going to be using for this demo. I tested it last night. As I said, I'm going to be using this for probably a lot of my meetings from now on because it is so cool. Okay, so what you will do essentially is create a run of show is what they call it. And what that is everything that you want to share on your screen, basically. So if you have slides that you want to have that you're walking through on your screen, you can pull those in via PDF. If you want to use their interactions, you can add those right into your run of show. So let me just kind of show you what that looks like. They do have some samples in here. I'll just go ahead and show you one that I created last night. So in my Life Ninja Academy, we do a live monthly results injection where I teach them how to really get hyper-focused in on what tasks they need to do for the month that are going to help increase their revenue, right? How to focus in on the right tasks to do. Okay. So I'm going to just hit edit so you can see them. So I have pulled in my slides. So like, if you see this first one, it says slide 2 to 3. I actually had my slides separated into multiple different files at the time from a different tool I was using. So I pulled them in all as separate files, but you can just pull in one PDF and select which files you want to end up in your run of show. You can drag and drop them. So like if I hit add slide right here, you would add your files. They'll show up on the right side here. If you click the little arrow, you'll select which ones you want to add in. So if you've got multiple slides showing there, you select those, then you hit the check mark and that will pull them right into this list right here. Then you're going to add your interactions. And like I said, you can drag and drop all of these in order. So in mine, for example, I have added this transient thoughts interaction, and I'm just telling them, check your My Task calendar view in Asana or wherever your tasks live. And I'm asking, what's one thing you accomplished last month that you're proud of? So this gives them an opportunity to type that into the chat. And while we're live, StreamAlive is going to bring that up on the screen in like a cool format. Okay. So it's just very engaging, and it's putting everyone's answers, not just in the chat, you know, but all other answers in the chat, it's putting them up on the screen for everybody to see. I have another one in here. This is like a word cloud. They're calling it Wonder Words. And so I'm just asking like, what one task or process or project are you going to be streamlining this month? That goes with the slide I have right before that. I'll show you that real quick. So I'm teaching them, you know, how to choose one recurring process or task to streamline, what kind of questions to ask themselves. And then as they're choosing, I'm going to do this word cloud, which allows them to type in the one task that they've chosen, and it will pop everybody's answers into a cool word cloud, right? So this is me just like getting them to engage. And I don't think I did any other types in here. There are a couple different interaction types, but I did add in this one, which is called quick questions. Now, quick questions, basically StreamAlive will look for anything in the chat with a question mark at the end of it. Okay. So it will look for questions in the chat. and it will organize them into a list for you. So if you add quick questions to your run of show, you can put it anywhere you want. I happen to be asking people to give me their questions at the end of my present or my training. So I've got it at the end, but basically what it allows me to do then is see a list of all the questions that have come in during the training, and I can just check them off as I go through them. So it helps to make sure if you have a very active chat in your live meeting, it helps to make sure that you don't miss anything. Okay, so that is kind of what a run of show looks like. This isn't going to be like a super duper in-depth of how to do every little thing and click every little thing, but I just want to show you kind of what this is capable of. So I am recording this with Zoom right now. And so I'm going to attempt to show you how I would use StreamAlive with Zoom and just kind of what that looks like from the like admin perspective. Okay, so I'm gonna pause this real quick. Oops, did not mean to pause the sharing. I need to pause the recording. Come back here. Okay, so I'm back on the home screen right here, and I'm just gonna click View Meetings under the Zoom card. Okay, and you can see I have one coming up on February 1st. I'm just gonna click Add a Meeting, and this will be our test. Okay. And then it just wants the Zoom link. Now this has to be a link of a Zoom meeting that has already been created, or possibly your regular like private meeting room. If you're just using that, because it needs to match up to the actual Zoom once you start your meeting. Okay. So I'm going to grab that. The way that I'm grabbing that, and I don't know if you can see this because I don't know if this part of it is recording, if the meeting controls are recording, but I just go to where it says participants in Zoom. If I'm already live, for example, like this, and I'm just going to copy the invite link. For you, you will probably grab that just from your Zoom area. Just go and grab the link for your upcoming meeting. Okay. And I'm just going to paste that right in there. I'm going to say this is happening right now. I wonder if I can put it to the exact time right now. Confirm. Okay. So you'll just make that match up to your actual meeting time. And then what you want to do is add your run of show to that meeting. So I'm going to select my LNA monthly results injection template. You have an opportunity here to probably like, yeah, it's just letting you view everything on there. It doesn't look like you're able to edit though. I'm just going to hit save. Yes, I do want to save that. Okay. So now you can see it's got the run of show on there, and I'm going to hit connect. Connect is what you will hit once your Zoom meeting, you're already logged into your Zoom meeting. So you will likely, if you're setting up a future meeting, you will likely set it up to have a waiting room so that you have a chance to get in there and kind of do this connection before you let everybody in. Okay. So you'll just, when you're ready for your meeting, you'll go into StreamAlive and hit connect on your meeting after you have opened up Zoom. Okay. And then hopefully this is still recording properly, and excuse the yellow rectangle. I was just trying to hide my email address on there because it's not my regular forward facing email address. And you're just going to hit start run of show once you get over here. So hopefully that's still recording my screen, and you can see this is my very first slide. Okay. So what you're going to do from that point on essentially is walk through all of your screen sharing slides and all your everything in StreamAlive from the StreamAlive tab that you have open. Make sure that in Zoom, you have your screen sharing turned on. So just whenever you're ready to show them this page, you'll want to just go into your Zoom and turn on your screen share. Okay. And just share this window. What you can do is click down in the bottom right-hand corner to make it full screen like this, so they're not seeing, like, as you could probably see, that you have like 87 different tabs open in your Chrome browser. They don't need to see all that, right? So you can make it big like this, all full screen. And you will just walk through your slides like you normally would. So you can either like click on the left here, you can click down below, got the numbering down here. Again, excuse the yellow rectangle. I think I could turn that off, but might be a waste of time right now. And you'll just walk through it. Okay. And as you see right here, when we get to that first interaction that I created in my run of show, here it is. So this is going to show them right at the top, the question. So it's, you know, here it is, check your My Task calendar. All right. What's one thing you accomplished last month that you're proud of, right? Share that with us. And I'm just going to click as the admin, I'll click start interaction and ask everybody to go ahead and comment in the chat what you're proud of that you did last month. Okay. Now, I don't know if I can get it to, I think I can get it to share. So I'm just going to go ahead and type something in here. So got StreamAlive. So proud of that. Okay. And what it should do, there you go. All right. So how cool is that, right? So as people start typing, it's going to start adding them to this screen, their answers. Okay. And when we're all done with that, we would move on to the next thing in here. You know, we'll walk through our different things and here's the next interaction. Now you can set up to only allow one answer each time. And that is how I've set most of these up, which is why I didn't show you answering twice, but you can set it up where each person can only answer one time essentially, or it'll only keep one of their answers. Okay, so here's the next one. What's something you're going to streamline this month? I'll say, I don't know, I'm just going to type blah, blah, blah. And there you see. And as people start commenting, all their answers will start showing up on the screen. And this one's going to create a whole word cloud for that. Okay, and you kind of get the gist of it. I want to show you about the questions though. Okay, there we go. The quick question. So if somebody has typed anything into the chat, which I'm doing right now, it's going to show up on this question screen. So you can see it's got my question up there that I just typed. Let me see. Okay. And every question that people have typed, everything with a question mark on it should pop into here. Okay. And it looks like it does the oldest or first questions at the bottom. So your newer questions will be at the top. I think the reason is because as you go through these, you'll check mark them and maybe you want the new ones to show up at the top. Okay. So for example, do I like pasta? Yes, I do. So, okay. I've answered that and I'll just check it off and it kind of grays it out. So that's StreamAlive. It's super duper simple. The one that I didn't show you that is really awesome, and I just didn't set it up on this particular run of show, is the map. So let me just stop sharing my screen here. Okay. So I'm going to also close out my StreamAlive. So let's see, when you are done with your Zoom, you're going to go ahead and hit F11 on your screen to close out of full screen mode. And then there's an option to disconnect right next to the full screen mode. It looks kind of like a broken link. You just click that to disconnect. That actually tells StreamAlive to go ahead and like process everything that happened in there so that it shows up in your analytics. How cool is that? But what I wanted to tell you about is the map option in the run of show. So let me just go and find that real quick. Okay, so I wanted to show you this magic maps interaction option that they have. So when your people come into your meeting, if you're asking them a question like, hey, you know, where are you coming in from? Type it in the chat, that type of thing. Like, hey, we love to see where our people are, right? Then as they are typing the location, if you're using this magic maps interaction, then it's going to start putting them up all over this cool map. Like, how awesome is that? So you'll start to see little dots or numbers pop up all over the map. You can customize all of these interactions, by the way, to your branding colors. I believe that is dependent on which tier you select in AppSumo if you're doing the lifetime deal right now, but you can customize that to match all of your branding colors as well. So with that, I think that's it. Let me know if you have any questions below. I really have just barely even tested this as of right now, but I know I'm going to continue using it because it's such an awesome tool. One thing I do really like about it, I've seen some similar tools where you can essentially, they'll create a QR code for you that you put into your presentation slideshow, and it allows people to kind of like hold up their cell phone and scan the QR code and type in their answer and then make that show up on your screen. And honestly, the times that I've seen that, it doesn't always run perfectly smoothly, but even if it does, it is really cool, but it does require them to
first of all, not be on their phone when they're watching your training, but it requires them to pick up their phone and find a QR app, which not a lot of people are tech savvy enough to even know that they have a QR app on their phone or have downloaded one, right? And then they have to fumble around with getting that going and then type it in into a different screen. And it's so cool, but it's just not quite there yet, right? It's just not an option for everyone to be able to use and use very smoothly. So this takes all of that mess out of it. It just makes it so all they have to do is type in the chat and cool stuff happens on the screen. It makes your presentation super engaging. And, people respond really well to that. I have seen StreamAlive used in other tutorials. And I was just really impressed with how excited people were to engage when this was happening. And so I think if you try it, you will really like it. Anyway, with that, I hope this was helpful to you. If so, please make sure to like and subscribe on my YouTube channel so I can keep making more videos like this and sharing more tools with you, more things to help you save time and mental calories running your business. And with that, I will say bye, Ninja.